Guys, welcome to my inverse Laplace transform class. You already studied what is a Laplace transform, what is the use of Laplace transform. If you want to solve linear differential equation from Laplace transform, it's not only required Laplace transform, simultaneously we have to know inverse Laplace transform. Because whenever I have to solve linear differential equation with boundary conditions, in such cases, we are using both Laplace and inverse Laplace transform. Therefore, before going to solve linear differential equation, we are going to know first what is inverse Laplace transform. Here, in the inverse Laplace transform, you don't have any particular formula what you have finding a Laplace transform. Now, with the help of Laplace transform, we are going to write what is inverse Laplace transform. Keep in mind, where I am going to apply inverse Laplace transform? Whenever the given function in the form of frequency, I am talking about your core subject. In the mathematics, whenever the given function in the terms of parameters say yes, in this my class, I consider parameter is yes. Whenever I have a function in terms of parameter, there if you want to find out the corresponding function, we are going to use Laplace transform. Based on your core subject, whenever having a frequency value, if you want to find a domain, time domain value, then we are going to apply inverse Laplace transform. Now earlier I told we don't have any particular formula just like Laplace. Now based on Laplace formula, we consider what is my inverse Laplace transform value. For example, Laplace transform of f of t is nothing but capital F of s. I told just now, where I am going to apply inverse? Whenever having a function in terms of parameter, that implies L inverse of f of s gives us the corresponding function. What is my function is? F of t. Like that. Now we already know that where we already studied in the Laplace. Now keep in mind inverse Laplace transform is very easy. You are much confident about what is Laplace transform of e power of at, sin at, cos at. Then only inverse Laplace transform is very easy. Therefore, Laplace transform of, you already know that one. What is Laplace transform of one is, we already calculated in my previous classes. 1 by s, that implies L inverse of 1 by s is nothing but what we get actually 1. Similarly, Laplace transform of e power of at, what is the Laplace transform of e power of at? 1 by s minus a, that implies L inverse of 1 by s minus a is nothing but what is that? E power of at. Okay? Now, Laplace transform of your sin at. What is Laplace transform of sin at? We already derived in my previous classes. It's nothing but a divided by a square plus a square. That implies L inverse of a is constant. They are not required by finding L inverse A, because you know that either you take A inside the inverse or keep it outside A, does not matter. Therefore, what we are going to take? L inverse of A square plus A square. That is enough. I don't want constant value. I'll keep constant value in the right hand side because A is a constant. What's the value here? 1 by A sin A t. Like that. Laplace transform of cos at is nothing but s divided by s square plus a square. Now s is not a constant, while finding inverse, therefore you can't keep s in the left hand side. Keep in mind, a is a constant here. L inverse of s must be there in the numerator divided by square plus a square. What is the function? Left hand side function. What is my function? Cos at. Yeah, that's why I think it's clear. If you want to know inverse, you must be confident with Laplace transform. The next another thing is, you know the shifting property. Laplace transform of f of t, we already know that is nothing but capital F of s. Then the shifting property says, then Laplace transform of e power of at f of t is nothing but capital F of s minus a. This is my shifting property in Laplace. That implies L inverse of capital F of S minus A is nothing but E power of AT into F of T. F of T is nothing but what? is all written on the board in terms of inverse. F of t is nothing but L inverse of first step, L inverse of capital F of t. Now this is way to apply shifting property in the inverse transform also. Other than that, Laplace transform of sin hyperbolic kt. What is sin hyperbolic kt here? You already know that a divided by a square minus a square. The difference between sin and hyperbolic plus here minus. That implies a is a constant. Therefore, L inverse of are required only 1 by s square minus a square. Now, I take a is a constant, that is nothing but 1 by a into sin hyperbolic cosine a t. Similarly, Laplace transform of cos hyperbolic a t is nothing but what is that actually? S divided by a square plus minus a square. That implies L inverse of S divided by a square minus a square is nothing but what actually? Cos hyperbolic of a t. Okay, fine. Next, Laplace transform of t power of n is nothing but what actually n factorial divided by s to the power of n plus 1. I am talking about only n is an integer. Yes, I am not considering n is other value. There I have another formula is gamma of n plus 1 divided by s to the power of n plus 1. That implies Laplace, L inverse, keep in mind n factorial is a power of t, is a constant value. It's not expecting n factorial, even though you don't have n factorial, that's n of 1 by s to the power of n plus 1, because n factorial is a constant, is nothing but t power of n by n factorial. This is nothing but inverse Laplace transform. Whenever having 1 by s square, 1 by s 2, 1 by s to the power of 4, now I am going to write that is t power of n by n factorial. By taking n, please take care, l inverse of 1 by s cube means, now first you write it in the form of n plus 1, means 1 by s to the power of 2 plus 1, then we get t square divided by 2 factorial. We can't get 3, t power of 3 divided by 3 factorial. Please take care for that. Now once you know this is not sufficient, sometimes we are going to use some more formula, Laplace transform of the shifting property, actually e power of a b t sin a t. This is a shifting property already derived in my previous classes. Laplace transform of e power of b t into sin a t is nothing but a divided by s minus d whole square. Instead of s, what we are expecting? S minus d plus a square. That implies L inverse of, not necessary a in the numerator, without a also, 1 by s minus d whole square plus a square is nothing but what? 1 by a into e power of a t into e power of b t into sin a t, e power of b t into sin a t. Similarly, Laplace transform of e power of b t into cos a t. Now this is we derived by using shifting property. Now this is nothing but s minus b, because numerator in the cos you have s minus b divided by s minus b whole square plus a square. If you have any previous my slides, so please go through that, they are easy to understand. Now this implies L inverse of, we can't keep s is outside because it's not a constant, s minus b divided by s minus b whole square plus a square is nothing but actually what we get actually. Now this is nothing but e power of bt into sin a t. Sorry, e power of bt into cos a t. cost 80. The next is the Laplace transform of e power of whatever 80 into t power of n is nothing but, you know what is Laplace transform of t power of n. What is Laplace transform of t power of n? N factorial divided by s to the power of n plus 1. We are not considered other than n is an integer. Now this is shifting property. Instead of s, what we are expecting, n factorial divided by s minus a to the power of n plus 1. This implies L inverse R, not necessary. I am expecting n factorial in the numerator because it's a constant. Either you keep it in numerator or take it as a cross multiplication, does not affect the value because it's a constant. 1 by s minus a to the power of n plus 1 is nothing but what actually? N o e power of a t into t power of n divided by n factorial. You must and should have to at least you remember this formula, then easy to solve the problem. For the inverse transform. I think these are the things you please try to keep in some way while solving further problem, very much useful. Thank you very much for listening my class. Only I did revision for how we get inverse transform from the Laplace transform. Now I am going to solve related to this in further my classes. Now if you like my videos, you please click my like button and also subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.